serial entrepreneur in Toastmasters for almost a year, Roy Cullen. Roy is going to deliver his speech from Advanced Communication Series manual, Speaking to Inform. And he'll be doing the first project. And the objectives of this project is to select and present useful information for the audience. And this presentation should be done in interesting way. And we should it should be also be easily understandable for you and then easily remembered. And Roy has from 5 to 7 minutes. Roy Cullen, please welcome.
I'm writing a book at the moment, and basically it's about how I can make change to the world, because it's not the way that I'd like to see it, and what I want to do is give solutions. So I broke it down into various chapters, and one of them is about the prison system. And what's actually good for me today is that we've got a lot of people from different countries, so later, if you've got some other suggestions, I would greatly appreciate it. In America, what you've got is not the highest incarceration rate, but the second highest. And I'm not sure if any of you have actually seen it, but they have like reality shows showing how they're carried on in prison, beating the crap out of each other, covered in tattoos to be in gangs and all this. And they're basically showing how it shouldn't be done. Like the percentage of people that actually come back to prison is 75%. I've actually seen that in some countries, it's 85%, which is kind of sad. I look at things differently. I think we should kind of, how we can stop this, how we can investigate it and check it out. If you look at the actual cost factor, when you arrest somebody, you have all the police that actually have to get the person. You have the courts, judges, prisons, building the prisons, and then maintaining, feeding them. I know that in Ireland, there was like, it was costing over €100,000 per inmate. Each country varies. So it ain't cheap. I think people, a lot of the time, they're committing a crime because of the circumstances that they've been brought into. They basically, they're hungry, they don't have shelter, they're trying to feed their family. Like Monica gave a great example there. They weren't robbing because they thought they were going to win the lottery. They were taking a chicken because they were hungry. You know, in reality, there's a lot of that going on. And do you think that, like, there's a lot of crime in the streets, people are being robbed and everything? If you've been robbed, I mean, I've had my motorbike robbed, and I've been robbed as well, and I know it's like, I know a few people have been robbed, so it's a horrible thing, and you kind of carry it with you. But if people are provided with the basic necessities, like food and shelter, crime rate really drops. I'll give you one example. When I was growing up, we used to all play on the street, all the games, and that doesn't seem to happen now because people, you know, you play chessies and you run up and down, breaking into each other's arms and everything, and you get to really know your neighbors. And there was one girl, really nice, but she was abused. And later, things went bad for her. She had like 12 kids, different fathers, and she ended up robbing somebody and got into prison. But it wasn't her fault. Somebody else had done that to her. A child fell into the river where I live, surrounded by people, and it was she saved the child. So is she a bad person? You know, people kind of judge somebody and say, well, you're guilty. But I looked at this person growing up, and that's the same with everybody. They might have an alcoholic parent or anything. So look at that when you look at the prison system. If you look at other countries, Holland, they've closed 20 prisons because they've got it right. They're closing prisons because they don't have prisoners. Sweden, they look how we can reduce the prisoners. They basically educate them, get them jobs and everything. In California, people, they've started teaching them, people that got degrees, instead of being 75%, it's down to 5.6%. So basically, you educate them. If they're technically, you know, mentally challenged, you teach them an apprenticeship. Teach them how to be a mechanic, a plumber, a carpenter,
then they can go to the workforce because that's why they're robbing, they don't have a job.
So,
I'm not sure that.
So, like, there's different ways to actually look at that. Solutions, when they're in prison, obviously you educate them. That's the main thing. Food, like, you don't let them, they're all doing drugs and everything. They're allowed to get away with what they want. You just stop that. That's totally controllable. But they do it, oh, let's keep them all happy. You don't do that. You don't give them crappy food with sugar and everything. Give them all natural ingredients. Even let them do the gardening themselves, because there's been prisons shown that that actually helps. They've even given them animals where they're showing compassion. And that's given great results. So instead of judging the different people, try to look at their journey. Why they became like that? Obviously, there's a few cases that need to be. There's serious mental issues or whatever that will never be changed. But if we all kind of look at it in a compassionate way, I think we can make change that will make a difference.